I want your opinion on common oil furnace problems.
Incomplete burns because there is a blockage somewhere, creating soot at best and puffbacks at worst.
I thought soot was normal for an oil furnace. After all, it is burning fuel.
No, not with a modern furnace with oil sprayed into the furnace chamber with air. You can check the pressure with a draft gauge.
What should I look for with the draft gauge?
There should be negative pressure over the fire with a draft gauge value of negative 0.02 in the WC. If the negative pressure is lower, the problem is a blockage in the heat exchanger or chimney.
There are two or three pressure gauge spots in the furnace.
The pressure in the smoke pipe should be negative 0.03 or 0.04. If the pressure is less than that or even a positive value, the chimney is blocked.
I did not realize a blockage could cause soot buildup, which can cause even more blockage.
Another problem oil furnaces have is the ignition.
I thought it had a pilot light.
Unless you have an old-fashioned oil furnace designed like a kerosene furnace, the oil furnace uses an electric ignition powered by electricity and a transformer.
Also known as, the thing that makes the spark that burns the fuel oil.
If the power to the furnace is off, like a trip circuit breaker or burned out fuse, the igniter won't spark and the control panel should turn off the fuel feed.
It has green lights that say it should be running.
Turn it off, then turn it all on and see if it sparks.
You're basically telling me to reboot it.
That does fix it sometimes. If it does not spark, take the wires off the igniter transformer and check the resistance with an oil meter.
What am I looking for?
If the oil meter says zero, the igniter needs to be replaced. If the transformer linked to the igniter reads zero, that needs to be replaced.
What other problems do oil furnaces have?
If you smell burned oil, the problem is a draft. If you smell unburned oil, the ignition is the problem if not a leak.
Assuming there is not an oil leak in the combustion chamber.
If the nozzle that sprays the oil is leaking, turn everything off and get that fixed before the next spark blows it up.
You know, I never thought I'd say this, but I'd be glad if the issue was just a flame switch so far from the spray nozzle the thing shuts off because it does not realize it is on.